My name is PJ McGuire, and I am the inventor of Wrapperoo, which is a t-shirt hair drying towel that doubles as a protective styling cape. So Wrapperoo is both a business as well as a product, and really what it is, it's about providing women, some men, as well as professionals, with a tool to get rid of the mess and stress of our hair and beauty routines by giving something that will be multi-purpose, it'll dry hair once it's wet, but also being a two-sided cape, it's able to handle all the drips, the spills, the serums, the sprays, as well as makeup and all the dry mess as well. I really got involved in the hair and beauty industry by mistake. This was not my background, not something that I had planned to do, but one morning I was getting ready on my way out the door and just realized that my hair didn't look as great as I wanted it to. I went back in the bathroom, threw a towel over my shoulders, I was putting some product in my hair, and unfortunately that product seeped all the way through the towel, down onto a silk blouse, and completely ruined it. So at that point, I just had the idea of there needs to be something to handle all the messiness, all the products, all the goop, and everything that I do for my hair and beauty routine. And since there wasn't anything on the market, I came up with Wrapperoo and ended up getting the patent on it last year. I would say the biggest challenge I've experienced as the inventor of Wrapperoo has been on the manufacturing side. I have unfortunately had two manufacturers go out of business in the process of getting ready for different large wholesale orders. And I just had to really figure out what to do and navigate things. And in navigating it, what I found is that there are collectives of women all over the city of Chicago who have come together and created small scale manufacturing that really allows you to be a bit more nimble and not have to manufacture 15, 20, 25,000 units at a time, but they can get them done very, very quickly. The way that I've changed my management style and really the way that I run my business since dealing with the manufacturing challenges is realizing that we do have a lot of local resources here in Chicago, and oftentimes those local resources provide an easier way of doing business that's actually much more cost effective and really cuts down on the amount of cash flow that you have to put up front. And the lesson that I learned from this is, I think it's a lesson that really goes across the board in all areas of life. And that lesson is to look for the actual lesson in everything that you go through. This was a nightmare situation. The manufacturer went out of business right before I needed a multiple thousand unit order for a large wholesale client. And I thought everything was just going to melt down, crash and burn. But when I finally got through everything and sat down and looked at it, I realized that, you know what? That lesson and that situation taught me that sometimes there is a better way of doing it, and things have to actually completely fall apart and melt down in order for you to realize that you can do things a better way. And by learning that lesson and really digging deep and looking at the situation and what I could have done differently, what I realized is that in that lesson, it provided me with everything I needed to move into the next phase of my journey and really take my business to the next level. The best business advice that I have ever been given was my first job out of college. I worked for Pfizer Pharmaceuticals, selling Viagra, among other very, very interesting products. And the lesson that I learned and the advice that I was given from my first boss there at the company was this. He would always say, time spent up front is time saved in the end. And I really take that to heart in my own business. And what that does is if you just, instead of having that sense of urgency that we have in business, where as soon as a problem arises, we immediately jump on it and we want to fix it right away. Sometimes you just have to take that time up front, think about it, plan, come up with a really good strategy so that you mitigate any possible damages, any mistakes in the long term by just slowing down a little bit and thinking before you speed all the way up. So in terms of challenges that I am expecting to face in the next few years, I really think it's going to be something in supply chain, really with distribution and fulfillment. There are so many changes happening right now in the industry as a whole. If you look at the way Amazon is doing business, if you look at the way a lot of other fulfillment and distribution companies that are changing the traditional methods of getting your product out there to customers. So I think for small businesses like myself, we really have to be prepared and ready for these changes before they actually happen so that we're able to cost effectively get our product out there to consumers, out there to our wholesale clients without causing too much disruption inside of our businesses.